For more on developments in Mali, we're now joined on the line by Kassoum Coulibaly, who's an economic strategist. Thanks so much indeed for joining us. So the June 5 movement is back on the streets, and they seem very determined that the president should go.
Yes, yes, yes. I can say the meeting we had yesterday was one of the biggest that has not been organized in Mali since the Independence Day, 60 years ago. So we can say that they are very, very hard determined. So they want the president to step down, not only the president, but also the prime minister and all the government and all the regime. So I think that we are at the level now without a very, very great dialogue between the two parties. I am afraid that the country will be broken down itself. So this is the situation now in the country. But today it's very, very calmed down, because early in the morning, the people who were sitting at the Independence Day have been pushed by the policemen in earlier this morning. And today the country capital is calmed down today.
So the ECOWAS mission, has that failed completely then?
Yes, I can say they have failed, because all of the propositions they have made to the president and the opposition to agree on has not been in agreement, I can say, because all of the solutions have not been implemented. Only the Constitutional Court has been implemented by so late, and the solution that has been proposed before has not been longer been implemented. And after the 23 people who have been killed by the policemen, there is no investigation now to say who are the people who have made this sad situation in the country. And today, I can say the high level of Imam Mahmoud Diko, who is leading the coalition opposition, he said that we don't want any more negotiation from ECOWAS. We want the president to step down in his prime minister and all the regime. And we are in a situation where there is no dialogue between the two parties, and something very bad from the country, from the other citizens.
All right. So the president has tried to make some concessions, some of which the ECOWAS mission put on the table. Are we saying that there's nothing he can do, nothing that he can offer, except his resignation?
We can do something, because at that point, I think that the person who has the solution is the president of the republic himself. I think that as a Malian, he has to call all of the stakeholders, all of the parties itself, against the M5 RSP. People, but also the all civil society, the traditional leaders, the religious leaders, the over private sector leaders, to come on a one table and to say that this is the situation we are in now. What can we do as Malians ourselves without any external intervention? I think that this is what the president should do now. Because if he continues to want to just implement what the ECOWAS facilitation leader said without getting the consent of the other parties, I think that he will continue to fail, and I'm afraid that they will get a coup very soon in the country. And this will be very bad for all citizens, but also for the whole region.
Are you fearful that we'll see more violence on the streets, and that the security forces, the police, may open fire yet again?
Yes, I can say yes, because if the policemen continue to bring violence on the streets, people have decided yesterday on the meeting, they will not allow anybody to kill them again anymore. They will start to take their auto-defense position. So they will try to find also what means of violence they can have to kill also the policemen, or to kill the ruling party people. So that we are at the point, if we don't go as soon as possible in a direct dialogue amongst the people who are fighting each other, the president and the opposition people. I am afraid that we are going to have a raging, violent situation in the streets. But not only in the streets, but also in the other capital cities in the province in Mali. You can say yesterday's meeting was not only in Bamako, it was all in the all big cities in the province, but also in international level where diaspora, Malian diaspora people are living. So this is the first, you know, international, you know, meetings we can have at the same time, and something they are very determined to the president to step down. So I think that this week we have time to have some solution, but if we go out this meeting, this week, can be very dangerous for all of the people.
All right.
So I can say that I don't want the situation, but this is something that can happen. But I trust the people can have a positive mind and the soul to say that this situation cannot continue more.
All right. So one of the issues that people have been concerned about has been his handling of the militants and the threat that they pose. Is this something that's beyond his control, or has he just failed to manage the issue?
I'm not sure it's out of the control, because, you know, we are Malian people. We are sociological linking each other. We are brothers and sisters. We are all maybe 95% of Muslim. It is like basically kind of one family. So why can we have time to sit together on a table and to discuss frankly on the solution we have? We have some very, very bad governance issues in the country, corruption, and people are not going to school since 2 years now. And there are some very, very big challenges with the terrorism, jihadism, and so on and so on. So I think that we have not on out of control, something positive can be done before the end of this month. So we need to put our all strength to together. And I call also the South Africa to bring on table as a facilitator, because the head of state of Africa now is the President Cyril Ramaphosa. And I can call him to come and to see the situation in Mali as a priority as an African. So we cannot let the ECOWAS to do, because the ECOWAS solution has failed. Now we want the AU to come on board. And I call personally the President Cyril Ramaphosa to have a look on Mali's situation so we can find a solution as soon as possible.